This video will demonstrate the far lateral craniotomy for excision and reimplantation of a ruptured posterior inferior cerebellar artery aneurysm. The patient was in her early 30s and presented with headaches and somnolence. On neurologic examination, she was lethargic. Her CT angiogram showed a fusiform aneurysm of her left pica with associated hydrocephalus and loculated subarachnoid fluid collections, which suggested a prior rupture. The aneurysm measured approximately 1 centimeter, as seen on the sagittal CT angiogram to the left. The catheter angiogram showed this to be a fusiform dolichoectatic aneurysm with a small segment between the vertebral artery and the aneurysm and a large distal efferent artery. A far lateral craniotomy was selected to treat this aneurysm, and this animation shows the patient position, skin incision, and the craniotomy used. Surgical strategy consisted of a far lateral craniotomy with an aggressive occipital condylectomy, dissection of the distal pica, early identification of the V4 segment and proximal pica for proximal control, attempted preservation of the proximal pica stump as a potential donor, aneurysm excision, trapping of the V4 segment with a long linear arteriotomy, end-to-site reimplantation of pica, and IC green video angiography to confirm graft patency. Here is an overview of the surgical exposure with this far lateral approach. The aneurysm is seen in the center of your screen, covered in thrombus. The top of the head is at the bottom of your screen, and the feet are at the top. The initial dissection began on the distal pica segment, coming from the aneurysm itself. This was traced proximally to the aneurysm. The aneurysm itself was densely adherent to the lateral medulla. Here, the distal pica is being freed from the wall of the aneurysm. This thick scar tissue indicated prior and probably multiple prior hemorrhages. Notice the accessory nerve, which was adherent to the sidewall of the aneurysm. Care was taken to preserve the accessory nerve and to mobilize it away. In addition, all of these perforators were carefully preserved. Here, the V4 segment is brought into view. This is the site of reimplantation later. First, an attempt was made to try and salvage the proximal pica here as a donor stump. The aneurysm is transected and rolled away. Here, a distal clip is applied to the distal pica. And you'll see here that there is poor flow through that pica stump. I was able to get it open, but the quality of the tissue here seemed poor, and so I made the decision at that point to go to reimplantation. The aneurysm here is excised completely. The distal end is transected obliquely and fish-mouthed. Here it's rotated into position, and there is good redundancy with adequate length to reach the vertebral artery. Here the fish mouthing is completed. Now the temporary clips are going on the vertebral artery, both distally and proximally, with some readjustment of the proximal clip. And this will be our landing zone for the reimplantation. My arteriotomy is made with a number 11 blade, and notice how thick-walled the vertebral artery tissue is. It's important to clearly visualize all layers of that vertebral artery wall. I'm using 9-0 monofilament nylon here, which has a healthy needle and a nice strong suture thickness. I use running continuous suture technique to sew this back wall. The suture broke, so I needed to place an additional suture here, and I'm also lengthening that arteriotomy. This widens the anastomotic area. Now I'm starting the second suture line by placing a second stitch here, and then I'm running this suture line here continuously, keeping the sutures loose until the end. This enabled a better visualization of all layers of that vertebral artery wall. The loops of suture are tightened and tied, and the anastomosis is opened. The clips come off, and now there's good flow in the vertebral artery, which feeds our reimplanted pica. There's our stump of the original pica, which is closed off permanently. There's our nice view of the reimplantation. And I see green video angiography confirms patency of the graft with good perfusion of the medulla and spinal cord. Here's a high-powered view showing the suture work. The aneurysm has been removed. You can see the reimplantation. And notice how this was a nice accessible window for landing the pica onto the V4 segment. These illustrations just demonstrate how the far lateral exposure is helpful for exposing that proximal V4 segment for the reimplantation. Note the vago-accessory triangle is the critical working space for the reimplantation, specifically the infrahypoglossal portion of that triangle. The vago-accessory triangle is shown in the illustration to the right with the infrahypoglossal segment shown in brown. The schematic to your left shows how the pica was reimplanted on the V4 segment of the vertebral artery. The illustrations to the right show the various options that are available for bypassing pica aneurysms. Pica aneurysms can be located in the anterior, lateral, or tonsillomedullary zones, and depending upon their depth, different bypass options are available. In this case, this was a P1 segment aneurysm, and options available included reimplantation, pica-pica bypass, or a graft. Pica-pica side-to-side bypass was not a good option because the contralateral donor pica was very small in caliber and part of an ica-pica system. The reimplantation turned out to be the best option. The patient tolerated the procedure well with no new neurological deficits. Here, her postoperative angiogram shows a beautiful reimplanted pica seen on the AP view to the left and a slightly oblique view to the right. Note the good flow in the distal pica territory. In conclusion, pica reimplantation is one of four intracranial bypass options for complex dolichoectatic pica aneurysms not amenable to clip reconstruction. Redundant length of pica, an accessible landing zone on the V4 segment, and long arteriotomies are needed to safely perform the reimplantation technique. Vertebral artery wall is thick and multi-layered and requires careful placement of full thickness bites. Other bypass options for this aneurysm included pica-pica side-to-side anastomosis, reanastomosis, and occipital artery to pica bypass, but reimplantation proved to be the better option. Thank you.